Hey guys, Pitmaster here. Everyone knows the left hook is my favorite punch. Let me show you four variations of the left hook, all of them equally effective. First one, bullfighter hook. Someone's rushing you, bullfighter. Move to the side, like a bullfighter. Number two, fish hook. Catch them coming, right in the chin, up at an angle, hurts like hell. Okay, number three is the follow me hook. Someone's rushing at you, it's a counter hook. Follow me, brother, counter hook, all right? And number four, one of the favorite of all times, the wrecking ball hook. Your hand's here, it's a hook. Hey guys, Pitmaster here. We got Vots right over here. We're gonna go over four of our favorite left hooks. Because left hook is our favorite punch, but I'm gonna show you four variations. First one's the bullfighter. Bullfighter is just like a bullfighter. Somebody's rushing you, you get out of the way with a hook. Now this might seem counterintuitive because you think you're moving away from the power, but believe me, if you're moving, it hits the chin, it'll knock someone out. How many times have you seen that knocked out?
Quite a bit.
Floyd Mayweather knocked out Ricky Hatton with it. I've seen like three knockouts in the UFC with it.
OSP knocked out Shogun with it.
It works. Basically, when you're moving away, you're still popping and you're aiming the right for the hip. So while you pop your hip, moving away, you're still creating enough power to knock someone out. Plus, you're getting out of the way. Number two, the fish hook. I like the fish hook when your hand's down here for whatever reason. Say you hit him with a body shot, or you just threw a right hand. Whatever reason your hand's here, it comes up at this angle, okay? This isn't as much of a knockout punch, but it hurts like hell. When it catches the chin at this awkward angle, a lot of times if the guy's not biting down hard on his mouthpiece or whatever, it really hurts. This one, the fish hook really hurts. So I like to throw it, like after you hit a body shot, you just come right back up to the face hook. It'd be like, body shot and then come up to the face. So the fish hook looks like a fish hook. That's why I call it a fish hook.
Not quite an uppercut, no?
No, it's not quite an uppercut. An uppercut would be here, fish hook would be here. Comes at a different angle. Fish hook, uppercut.
Got it.
Anyway, follow me. Like if you're in the infantry, in the army, and you're telling everyone, follow me, that's what the follow me hook is. That's why I named the follow me hook. The guy's rushing you, if you want to knock him out, but you're like telling him, follow me, and you're going that way. So you're like, someone's rushing you, catch him with the hook, and step him back. Okay, so you're creating distance, boom, catching him with the hook, step him back. All right, that's the follow me hook. Fourth one, the wrecking ball hook. The wrecking ball hook, made famous by people like Floyd Patterson. He called it the gazelle punch, but it was the same thing. He leaped in with his hand here, and then he would bring it up like a hook. You also seen Tommy Hearns fighting like this, like his hand was a wrecking ball. He would come up with a jab or a hook. Okay, so I've seen it used a lot. I just named it wrecking ball. And the thing I like most about the wrecking ball hook is it gets out of your opponent's line of vision. So if he's looking at you now he can't see your hand, then it comes up to the chin. So you see it, watch, you can't see my hand now. It's here, it drops, then it's there. That's the wrecking ball hook, okay? So those are four of our favorite variations of our favorite punch. So there's subsets to our set, which is the hook. And thanks for coming.